Instrument flight rules, also known as IFR, and visual flight rules, also known as VFR, are the two sets of rules for operating any aircraft. VFR essentially exists to ensure that pilots flying visually don't lose visibility up in the clouds and crash into each other. Since air traffic control is not responsible for keeping VFR planes separated, it's up to the pilot in command to avoid a collision. This means that the pilot needs to be able to see in front of and around the aircraft while flying.
What does happen to VFR pilots is something called spatial disorientation when you get into the clouds. If you're not equipped to fly on instruments, it's very easy to quickly lose your spatial orientation. A lot of instrument training has to do with ignoring your body, the vestibular system, in terms of like turning or what your attitude is, climbing or descending, and it's almost always wrong. So you really have to believe your instruments, what your instruments are telling you is going on to maintain straight and level flight. And a lot of VFR pilots can get into trouble when they get into low or no visibility conditions. They can lose control of the airplane within seconds.
Steve Thorne has more than 15 years of VFR flying experience, but a routine flight in 2014 turned dangerous in a matter of minutes.
I found myself, I did everything I thought I was doing correctly from a VFR flight planning perspective, and it was a winter flight, and I basically found myself encountering lake effect snow that was not forecast to be where it got, but it was extremely strong winds that brought it further south than it was supposed to be. It's not typical that it will close in around you from all directions. I probably could have turned back and gotten back into clear skies, but I had get-there-itis in this case, and I was close to home. I knew the area where I was flying over the lakeshore from heading towards the Toronto Island Airport, and I kind of just followed my visual reference on the ground, and I knew the landmarks, but the visibility was closing in on me quite tightly, and there was a real possibility that if it continued, I may not have been able to see the airport to land. When you're in the clouds and there's minimum vectoring altitudes and there's minimum en route altitudes, there are times you can operate below those minimums and then you're kind of at your own discretion.